Hi, I'm Dr. Nirpuri. I'm a psychologist and I'm here to talk about sexless marriages. And as I've shared, there are over 40 million people in sexless marriages and millions of couples who, after the honeymoon and having kids, have problems in the bedroom. It is a global phenomenon with the economic crisis that it trickles down into the bedroom. But what I want to talk about is something different, which is that marriage is supposed to be a spiritual union. And as someone who's been a closet Christian for most of my life, not talking about what a big impact that my faith has on all of my decisions, I think it's really important to be very open about this. My belief is when you look at faith, and for example, you look at Christianity and marriage was supposed to be a spiritual union. And yet what we have in our religious institutes are these prejudiced kind of puritanical ideas. You can't marry across religion, you can't marry someone of a different race, all sorts of impediments to love. And yet marriage is supposed to be the most loving, accepting spiritual union out there. But what's happening is there's a lot of marriages where that's not the case, and the message they get from the church is you're not supposed to ever end your marriage. But then you lost sight of the spiritual purpose of marriage, which is spiritual, emotional union where you grow together. And there are many situations where people have grown apart. One may become very spiritual and the other one may not care. And that's not compatible and that's not good enough. And I think if you look at all the religions, they'll talk about that your duty to your partner is to be emotionally connected, to be spiritually connected, to nurture each other. And so now people think because they feel from the religious institutes they're supposed to stay in it, they're miserable, they're growing apart, and they're living in separate bedrooms, and their soul's dying. And so you have to have the courage to really look at your marriage and say, no way am I going to live my life based on prejudice and stereotypes and ruin my growth as a person and a spiritual being. You've got to sit down and look at, are you happy with your marriage? Are you emotionally fulfilled? Are you spiritually fulfilled? You will probably have a physical disconnect if you don't have that. Then you need to talk to your partner. Hey, are you happy? Are we connected like we used to be? Is there something missing? Is there something that I could be doing for you? Who are you? Who are you as a spiritual person? How are you growing? And how can we grow together? And there's some cases we're going to make a really hard decision where they're not growing with you and you're spiritually in totally different lands. Who you met and who they become is incompatible. And you're going to have that discussion. But in the end, if you follow your faith and you create that connection, that union, you're going to have the best emotional and physical connection in a marriage possible. And in some cases, you may want to talk to me about when you have to walk away and it may be hard. So you can go to my website, I'm Dr. Neera Puri, and my website is thebayareacoach.com, and you can find someone who's going to be loving and accepting and without prejudice and really connected to the real version of God and have a safe space to talk about what to do about your marriage. Thank you so much for your time.